Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This morning, boys and girls, as we prepare to celebrate our Mass, let us remember how much the Lord loves us and forgives us of all of our sins. As we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie.
Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, God loves you and he has chosen you as his own special people. So be gentle, kind, humble, meek, and patient. Put up with each other and forgive anyone who does you wrong, just as Christ has forgiven you. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is kind.
to anger and rich in mercy, for as the heavens are high above the earth, so strong his mercy for those who fear him. The Lord is kind and merciful.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Don't condemn others, and God will not condemn you. God will be hard on you as you are on others. He will treat you exactly as you treat them. You can see the speck in your own friend's eye, but you do not notice the log in your own eye. How can you say, 'My friend, let me take the speck out of your eye,' when you don't see the log in your own eye? You're nothing but show-offs. First, take the log out of your own eye. Then you can see how to take the speck out of your friend's eye." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This gospel, boys and girls, always sounds a little weird and odd, because the reality is we know that sometimes maybe we do get like a little speck in our eye or something, but if we had a log in our eye, it would be very uncomfortable, and most likely it would blind us. And so that's not really Jesus is talking about logs and specks. He's just using that as an example, because he's talking about how easy it is sometimes to point out the faults and how somebody else is messing up when we don't look at ourselves. Like, for example, if we get mad at someone for doing something and we know we've done the exact same thing, then we're being kind of hypocritical. And so that's what Jesus is really talking about, not judging each other, looking at our own lives. Because people are just naturally, they like to point out faults in other people. I mean, they like to pick on people or point out, you know, "Well, you didn't do this right," or "You didn't do that right." Has that ever happened to any of you? Yeah, where someone's told you, "Well, you didn't do this right or that right." Well, that's not really our job. That's not what Jesus is telling us that we need to do. He's saying we should not stop judging, but we should also forgive as we ask the Lord to forgive us. So when we think about pointing out somebody else's mistake or things that they do, we always have to look in the mirror and look at ourselves. And a lot of times there's an old saying that if there's something about someone that drives you crazy, a lot of times you might be doing the exact same thing and may not even be aware of it. Like, I had a friend one time who used to just do this all the time, you know, on like this all the time when he was sitting at a table, and it would drive me crazy. And one day I said, "Stop that, it's driving me crazy." And I looked down and I was doing the exact same thing. So, you know, sometimes that does happen. Well, boys and girls, next week is Thanksgiving, and in spite of all the chaos, we still have much to be thankful for, but I just hope all of you have a good Thanksgiving. Please remember, you know, to be careful, wear our masks. We can't let our guard down, because we want to be able to come back and have school up until Christmas, and we certainly want to be able to celebrate Christmas. And so this Thanksgiving may be a little bit different, but it's still, we have much to be thankful for in spite of all that's going on in the world. Let us pray.
For the Catholic Church, for Francis our Pope, Paul our Bishop, and for all the bishops, priests, and deacons, may the Lord bless them greatly in their work. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our president, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, that they will govern wisely and justly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful, that we may strive to better imitate daily the life of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and the unemployed, for those suffering from depression or addiction, and for all those in any kind of danger, that the Lord will help them in their time of need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the canonization of Father Stanley Reuther, that we may soon have a saint from our own archdiocese, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, and for all of our seminarians, that the Lord will continue to guide them in their formation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through the intercession of Saint Mathilda, there may be a swift end to the coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they may find eternal rest and peace in Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own needs and intentions that we now recall in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we ask you to hear these prayers and those that we hold in our hearts. Continue to show us your mercy and your love, and we ask this all through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Remember all those named in the book of the dead. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb.
No.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Before we go today, let's thank those who prepared Mass for us today. Thank you, guys. Please stand. For the end of this pandemic and all the damage that it has caused, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Blessed Stanley Rother.
Pray for us.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
TV on.
Drake, you don't have a horn.
Oh, it's okay.
Not done yet.
He's gonna watch it. I think the Price is Right comes up.
Not done yet.
Thank you, guys.
Did you turn it off?